When researching people groups in the world, it is very rare that one would be able to come across the progenitors of an entire race and accurately pinpoint their geographic origins. However, there is a group of people in Taiwan which has ties to nearly half of the countries of Southeast Asia and even many beyond those borders, which has made them a group of extreme interest for many years now. I say race because for a very long time in human anthropology, European anthropologists considered most Southeast Asians to fall under the category of what they called the Malay race. Although this terminology is no longer widely used, with this vast array of people instead being better known as the Austronesians. Austronesian peoples, meaning those who speak an Austronesian language as a mother tongue, dominate many countries around the Indian and Pacific Oceans today, and include such diverse groups as Malays, Filipinos, and Balinese, while groups like the Malagasy in Africa, or native Hawaiians of the Polynesian region, may also be considered Austronesian peoples due to linguistic and genetic affiliations, although these groups also include admixture from surrounding sources. Today on the planet Earth, members of the Austronesian language family account for nearly 17% of all human languages, or over 1,200 distinct and identifiable languages, with Austronesian speakers only accounting for a mere 5% of all humans on the planet. While for comparison, Indo-European languages account for only 6% of all identifiable languages, while Indo-European speakers make up 46% of the human population, which goes to show the abnormal amount of diversity among the Austronesian peoples. This can largely be attributed to the vast area Austronesian peoples inhabit, as well as a unique phenomenon seen among inhabitants of islands and archipelagos, which results in population drift through isolated gene pools and language pockets. One thing is clear, Taiwanese Aborigines are absolutely not a homogeneous group from an ethnic, linguistic, or religious standpoint. And in case you are curious, no, they have absolutely nothing to do with Australian Aborigines. Now, for many years, the Austronesians of Taiwan were actually believed by such colonizers as the Dutch, British, and Japanese to be migrants out of Southeast Asia who settled in the mountainous interior of the island, and this thought was actually widespread up until the 20th century, when overwhelming evidence actually suggested it was the other way around. One of the best evidences of the Taiwanese origin of the Austronesians is the extreme amount of internal diversity among Taiwanese Aboriginal peoples, not seen anywhere else in the Malay archipelago, which almost always suggests an origin point for an ethnicity or language. There is evidence of some Melanesian or Negrito admixture in Taiwanese Aborigines today, groups that were previously widespread throughout all of Southeast Asia, although this can be contributed to early reverse migrations of admixed Austronesian sailors from Malaya traveling back to Taiwan throughout the thousands of years. It is now believed that the Austronesians were instead native to Southeast China before their introduction to the island of Taiwan and subsequently Southeast Asia, and Proto-Austronesian peoples may have been related to early Thai, Austroasiatic, Hmong, or even Sinitic peoples, although Chinese linguists are the only ones who commonly accept this hypothesis. There's also evidence that ancient Austronesians inhabited much of the southern coast of China and possibly even as far north as Japan and Korea, and some even postulate that the Ainu, Japanese, and/or Korean languages are also branches of a separate wave of migration from Taiwanese Austronesians that went north, although again this is highly dubious and not backed up by most studies. Through the span of 1,000 years, Austronesians spread out south from Taiwan to take up most of the Malay archipelago, mixing with the Negrito and pre-Austronesians to form the modern populations, although only around 40% of the genes of Southeast Asian Austronesians can be attributed to this wave of migrants. We've already discussed Southeast Asian demographics and history several times, so I won't go into much more detail, and instead let's focus on the far more localized topic of what happened to the last of the Aboriginals that remained in Taiwan while their descendants were spreading out throughout the world. It actually wasn't until the 1200s that outsiders first began to visit the island of Taiwan through Chinese fishermen, and it wasn't until 400 years later that large-scale migration to the island from the Chinese mainland began to take place, mainly because of the initial hostility of the Aborigines to outsiders. The name Formosa actually came from the Portuguese, who first stumbled across the land in 1544. And interestingly, the first to colonize the island were not the Han Chinese, but the Europeans, namely the Dutch, who established a colony on the southern half of the island in 1624. And by this time, Taiwan was inhabited nearly exclusively by Aborigines, although shortly after this, large numbers of Han Chinese from the Qing dynasty began to settle along the coast, along with perhaps a few hundred Dutch families, mostly missionaries set on converting the Aboriginal population to Christianity. The Spanish also had a couple of short-lived colonies on the island in the north in the form of Fort Santo Domingo and San Salvador, and the two battled for control over the island, with Spain originally having the advantage with constant reinforcements from the neighboring Philippines, although as the Dutch East Indian Company grew in power, the Dutch would eventually come to dominate most of the island, allying themselves with the Qing dynasty. During this time, the Aborigines numbered perhaps no more than 100,000, with a handful interacting with the Dutch missionaries, converting to Christianity, learning Dutch, and largely becoming westernized, although all this changed when the general/warlord Zheng Shengang, also known as Kokshinga, invaded the island in 1661. Kokshinga was born in Japan of half Chinese, half Japanese ancestry, although he remained strictly loyal to the previous Ming dynasty of China rather than the Manchurian-backed Qing, and invaded Formosa, overthrowing the Dutch East India Company, killing and expelling the men, and taking the women and children as slaves, with many Aborigines split between supporting the Dutch and Kokshinga's forces. Although Kokshinga died of malaria the following year, the Chinese loyal to the Ming dynasty remained on the island until 1683, when the Qing dynasty finally took over the island from Ming control, renaming the island Taiwan Prefecture, with large numbers of Han Chinese from Fujian province flooding the northwest corner of the island. The Aboriginals remained highly isolationist and hostile towards outsiders, often attacking Westerners, Japanese, and Chinese travelers alike. Although contact between the new Chinese migrants and Aboriginals living near the coast resulted in many learning Hokkien Chinese. By the time the Japanese took control of the island of Taiwan, Taiwanese Aborigines made up less than 5% of the population, divided into two groups, with the mostly Sinicized Chinese-speaking Aborigines inhabiting the western plains, while the more traditional, isolated Aborigines resided in the mountainous interior and were far more exclusive to outsiders. And by the year 1910, Aborigines were reduced further to 4% of the population of the island, supplanted by further Han Chinese immigrants, as well as increasingly larger minorities of ethnic Koreans and Japanese. The policy of Imperial Japan towards the Aborigines varied, with the Plains Aborigines treated mostly the same as the Han Chinese, although in order to facilitate the assimilation of the Taiwanese Aborigines into Japanese society, the Japanese specifically targeted isolated rural Aboriginal communities for its policy of Japanese-only education, which did indeed produce a far more loyal group of soldiers, as the ethnic Koreans and Chinese on the island were initially not very accepting of Japanese rule. After Japan's defeat during World War II and the returning of Taiwan to China, the Chinese Civil War also greatly affected Taiwan's demography, as an unprecedented wave of Chinese flooded the island from the mainland, further reducing Aboriginal significance on the island. Today, there are more Taiwanese Aborigines than ever located on the island, albeit in a much smaller percentage than in any point in history, as despite numbering over 500,000 people today, this accounts for a meager 2.3% of Taiwan's population, as the Aborigines simply could not compete with the massive waves of Han Chinese immigrants over the centuries, and undoubtedly a seriously high percentage of Aboriginal children have been assimilated into the mainstream Chinese culture, as it's actually been found through genetic studies that over 75% of the Han Chinese inhabitants of Taiwan have at least some Aboriginal ancestry, although this study didn't include more recent Chinese migrants from the mainland. Nevertheless, there are very large stretches of the island which have remained virtually untouched by the Chinese influence, as despite making up only 2.3% of the Taiwanese population, Taiwanese Aborigines make up the majority in over 40% of the land area on the island, as the coastal cities have a far higher population density. The largest single Aboriginal group today are the Amis, located on the southeastern coast and making up nearly 40% of the entire pure-blooded Aboriginal community. Although, as stated before, the island has the single highest degree of diversity of any Austronesian group, and although every group is different, many Taiwanese Aboriginal people are noteworthy for their widespread facial and body tattoos that are prominent among both men and women. Also, according to most recent statistics, about 76% of all Taiwanese Aboriginals practice some form of Christianity, compared to only 5% for the entire island of Taiwan as a whole, with around 8% adhering to Buddhism, Confucianism, or a combination of Eastern religions, with the remainder exclusively practicing the native animistic faith of the Aboriginals. Although truthfully, animistic practices are still widespread among the overwhelming majority of all Aboriginal groups. One interesting aspect of Taiwanese demography today is the influx of large numbers of migrants, almost exclusively from neighboring Southeast Asia, but overwhelmingly from the countries of Malaysia, Indonesia, and the Philippines, which, if you've been paying attention, you would realize are at least partial descendants of ancient Taiwanese migrants. So, in a way, the 400,000 non-Aboriginal Austronesians in Taiwan are a form of reverse migration. So, indeed, to many Austronesian peoples today, the Taiwanese Aboriginals are seen as the original colonists who paved the way for the formation of countless nations and people today, and despite not having the grandest of histories, they still have one of the most unique backstories as the last surviving precursors of one of the world's largest language families. So go ahead and let me know your thoughts on the Taiwanese Aboriginals and other Austronesians, and be sure to check out today's poll in the top right-hand corner. And as always, thank you all for watching. This has been Mason, and I will see you all next time.